Access options for Visual Studio subscriptions. There are two main options your subscribers have for accessing their Visual Studio subscriptions: a Microsoft account or a managed tenant. What exactly are these? In this video, we'll explain each option, show the impact of choosing a type of account on your subscribers, and share some of the benefits that come with managed tenants, such as improved security and ease of subscription management. What is a Microsoft account, or MSA? A Microsoft account, commonly referred to as an MSA, is a personal email account owned by an individual, used to access Microsoft services when an organization isn't using a managed tenant, such as M365 or Microsoft Entra. An MSA is set up by the individual and maintained by the individual. For example, Kai may have set up kai.carter20@outlook.com as his MSA. This would be created, owned, and maintained by him. Why would subscribers need an MSA? Companies use MSAs when they're not using managed services by Microsoft, such as M365 or Microsoft Entra, or if they're using managed services from other companies. For example, Kai Carter was assigned a subscription by his company, Contoso. His admin assigned it to his company email, kai@contoso.com. However, since the email is owned and managed on-premises by Contoso, Kai needs to make this email account a Microsoft account to access his subscription. Are there governance risks to using an MSA? Since Microsoft accounts are owned by an individual, there are several points to consider. First, any company policies your organization has defined for account security, like password strength, won't apply to that MSA. Additionally, if the individual is no longer with the company, they can still access services that are connected to their identity. For example, if Wesley Brooks used his own MSA, wesley.brooks01@outlook.com, to assign Visual Studio subscriptions and manage admins, he would still be able to do this even after he leaves the company if his account is not removed from the Visual Studio subscriptions admin portal. To remove Wesley's access, another admin would need to log into the admin portal to remove his permissions. This can pose a security risk to your company if the user maintains unauthorized access to confidential information. What options do I have to increase governance? If your organization uses a managed tenant, consider assigning subscriptions to the users within the tenant for a more seamless management experience. A managed tenant is a cloud-based directory that allows the organization to have end-to-end control over the user's access to Microsoft services. This can be achieved through a hybrid or full cloud solution, such as M365 or Microsoft Entra. Unlike MSAs, managed tenants allow your company to have increased governance and full control over a user's access. For example, let's say that Wesley Brooks is an admin and uses wesley@fabricam.com to manage Visual Studio subscriptions and admins. When Wesley leaves Fabricam, as soon as his email address is deactivated, he no longer has access to product keys, Azure resources, or other sensitive and confidential information. Wesley also doesn't need to set up and maintain his own email account as he would with an MSA, since the sign-in and security for Wesley's email address is within Microsoft Entra and entirely in the control of his company. Once his account is deactivated, he loses access to cloud services. Wesley may still temporarily show in the admin portal if he was added as an individual rather than as part of an Entra group. Entra groups automatically populate changes to users across tools and environments. Is it possible for subscribers to use an M365 or Microsoft Entra work email for their MSA? Yes, your subscribers can create a Microsoft account out of their work email. For example, let's look at an organization that is using a managed tenant, like M365 or Microsoft Entra. The organization assigns Hannah an email address of hannah@fabricam.com. Now the Visual Studio subscriptions admin assigns a subscription to Hannah's Fabricam account. Hannah should use this email address and the corresponding password that already exists through her organization to access the subscriptions portal. If instead she chooses the option to create an account with her Fabricam email, she will be creating an MSA. This means that even if Hannah left Fabricam and she had used that email address as an MSA to sign into other services like Visual Studio subscriptions, that would still be her user sign-in. Using an M365 or Microsoft Entra email as an MSA still provides some ease of administration benefits at the cost of security risk. The Visual Studio Subscriptions Admin Portal will recognize all of your users and be able to track the status of their email accounts. The system will identify when a person's account is deactivated in Microsoft Entra and remove access to the subscription. However, the subscription will still be listed in the portal until it is removed by the admin. If the company admin deletes a user out of Microsoft Entra instead of just deactivating them, access to the Visual Studio subscription will be automatically removed within 30 days. In our example with Hannah, while she created an MSA with her Microsoft Entra ID, her access to the Visual Studio subscription will still be restricted by default if a company admin removes her from Microsoft Entra. This enhances compliance thanks to the use of Microsoft Managed Services. If your organization migrates to a managed tenant, you as the Visual Studio admin can migrate subscriber access from consumer domains like Hotmail or Outlook by using the Connect Emails function in the Manage portal. This feature looks at the subscriber's sign-in email address and changes it to their account within the managed tenant, increasing governance. For information about the Connect Emails function or on managed tenants such as M365 or Microsoft Entra, see the links in the description below. Visit manage.visualstudio.com today to assign and manage your subscribers.